Okay, just to let the people know on live stream, we are just getting going here and should be starting shortly. And this is the blueprint teaching for Wednesday, November 4th, 2015, the continuation of the Blueprint Teaching Week from last week at the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute with Mr. Keshe. Back to your music from Pia, courtesy Pia.
Thank you. Hello, Vancouver. We are ready to go. With what?
Okay, that sounds good. Can we fade out on the music, please?
Yes, okay. We are ready to go.
All right. Let's get your video up there.
It's open. Who opened that? You open it. Okay, never open it, please. We forget they walk in. Close it. Close it.
Okay, well,
yesterday, not yesterday, before, I came up to the room in the hotel, and I was passing, I saw a door open.
We're live, Mr. Keshe, if, unless you...
I want to switch up.
Okay. So, just to let everybody know, this is the beginning of the Blueprint Teachings for Wednesday, November 4th, 2015. This will be a continuation from the teachings from last week's Blueprint Teachings Week at the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute with Mr. Keshe. And it looks like we're just about ready to go here, I think. I hear some whispering in the background, so we must be just about there by now. Mr. Keshe, are
you? Yes, good morning. We have a bad lighting. It's the images repeating themselves. Good morning to you. Good day to you. This is part of the Blueprint Day. We, as we promised, we come back till somebody will announce the result of what they achieved. But there seems to be some problems with some people. Understanding of the winding of the copper springs. I had to think a lot in how you lot are getting it all the other way around and wrong way around. And this morning we discussed it with our guys who understand these things, and then we spoke with the factory that understand these things. And it's a very easy solution to it. And I've asked Vince, and hopefully when I start explaining it, everything else, how to do the winding on the blueprint will be withdrawn, and this will become the replacement for it. That from now on, everybody knows, when we talk about the winding, doesn't matter what terminology you use, we call it the winding of the coil for the power unit, for gravitational magnetical unit. We started from now that they can record it and take it out. If you take a normal hand drill, this is the easiest way to do it. When you have a hand drill, you hold the drill in your hand, facing the direction where you want to put your attachment to it. On a normal hand drill, you have a forward and a backward. What it means, when you want to drill a hole, you press forward, you push in. If you want, for example, to screw into the wall with a hand screw, you push it forward. It goes clockwise, away from you. But they all have a button which you can reverse it, which means you try to take the screw out, which goes anti-clockwise or unwinding. Put your drill onto anti-clock, which is unwinding position. Put the bar which you want to produce, if you can open it, you should be able to open it. You put your bar in the drill, which you tighten it. You put your copper wire into the grooves, some whatever way you can tighten it that it stays in the jaw of the drill. And once you've done that, you're all experts. I'm the most lousy guy with the hand drills and these things. Even I've done engineering, I always hate tools. So what do? You tighten your bar, your copper wire, and all you do, just switch it on. You start the first rotation with it as it goes. If I can clip it, this is a very fine, because we don't have a gauge 14 with us here in the center. What I'm going to do, I'm going to tighten it a couple of times that it has the body to be gripped. All you do, you turn the machine on and let it run away from you. And that's all you need to do. This is how you call it clockwise, anti-clockwise. That's how you make your swing, the coil. Very easy. You make it tighter as you like. You can make it open as you like. But now we've answered all the questions. How do you make it? If it's a right hand screw or a left hand clockwise, whatever. This is how it should be. This end is your, this end which is towards the machine where we started, is your gravitational, or if it's your center core, is the input, and the other end is the output. As simple as this. So all this misunderstanding about the magnetical and gravitational is resolved. If you look at the wire, it looks as is clockwise, but it's actually winded anti-clockwise. It's as simple as doing it this way. So a lot of you who had problem with this, you see it, this is what it's called anti-clockwise, because when you look at it from the field coming out, you see the bend. It's the field flow. So the way we do it and the way it's been done, it's this way. Doesn't matter how you call it. The winding for the coils, you place it in your drill. If you have a screwdriver, other people who use the screwdrivers, you hold your screwdriver and you turn backwards with your screwdriver. That's all it is. The turning of the coil is, of the beam, is anti-clockwise, and that's what we're looking for. That's what is called anti-clockwise turning. You turn your screwdriver, or if you have a machine, you put it, you face the wire towards yourself, and the machine builds up to the numbers you need. So this is the coils, you call it whatever we've taken with this way. Any question about the winding is clockwise, anti-clockwise, out of the equation. So straightforward, put it, put your bar, assemble your, or push your end of wire into it, and just turn the drill as you are going reverse. Yes. Yes. No, you have to understand the difference. There are two separate conditions. One is making the coil, and one is connecting the coil. There are two different sections. Yeah? The way you do the making of the coil has nothing to do the way you connect them. So when you make two coils, one magnetical, one gravitational, your magnetical and gravitational both go through the same condition. You put one inside the other. When you connect it, when you make your loop, then you go by the principle of what you have, what you call your gravitational loop, and what you have in your magnetical loop. Yeah. So you connect because you have, this is one set. Then you have a bigger set which sits outside. We have the gravitational, and then you have a magnetical. So maybe let's do a different way to stop the confusion. I'm going to go backwards. Let's take this out. Let's take this out altogether. I don't know what's this. Okay. If you take this out, and we call this the inner ring gravitational magnetical, and then we call this one the outer ring magnetical. I take purple, and this is the gravitational, the magnetical of the outer ring. So if you call it 1, 2, 3, and 4. What do you do? Because don't forget, with your magnetical, you have a slight difference in the coil, and that is you have turned this magnetical once inside itself only by a copper line. Yeah? And then you've done the same. You have turned this with, I choose another color, yellow. You have turned this inside itself by a second line. Yeah? This doesn't matter. So the way you connect is the gravitational here of the inner ring, because it is inner clockwise. You go to the gravitational ring of this one, you connect here. So you go from two gravitational, the inner gravitational to the outside gravitational. Oh, sorry, yeah, you're right. No, it's correct. Don't tell me the outside, I'm right. Because this is, right, sorry. You connect, we put the yellow back on, the green. The yellow back up here. So you have the green, which is the beginning of it, end of this gravitational. We go to blue, which we chose that way. Then all the connections are in blue. Here you connect your gravitational end of this. And then it goes through where it comes back. You have this here. Yeah. When it comes back, you go from gravitational end to the magnetical of this end. And then, because you go, no, it's a counterclockwise. You go, That's correct, yeah. We go from there to here, and then you go from this here to here, and then you have your two ends. This end goes to your unit as magnetical, and you have this end of the red here, which is your negative gravitation. You connect your grid or the other tray to this point, the power goes around, it goes to the gravitational beginning of the other coil, it goes clockwise, it comes out, you connect it back to the inner center magnetical, anticlockwise, and then you connect it to the outside and you take your power from it. Don't forget, this is something some of you we repeat because we are process of explaining to make everything easier. When you make these coils, this is what is being said. Some of you might have heard, some of you might not. A lot of you know. We came with this with the situation with Sandor using a very tough copper. Is before you nanocoat, once you make your coils, this is what we're doing in the factory now. You heat up your copper wire ends, this ends. You heat them up just to below melting, that they soften. You bend them. You make all your connections with the wiring, and then you nanocoat. You've seen Richard doing it. A lot of people have a problem. We had this problem in the factory as well, where these are hard wires to work with. But once you anneal them, it's known as annealing, which is you heating to soften up. You do all your connections, you bend the ends, then you're safe with your work. So the process is very rapid, and as some of you know, you can make the three stacker, the nine stacker, six stacker, or above. There is something I have to explain, or we got to announce, is that the units have already left the factory. The shipping has started. We please wait till at least end of next week. If you don't see your units by end of next week, we tell you the tracking number. We give you, because we don't want to cause problem for the what I call the enemies of the foundation. The shipping has gone through a secure way. We hold the shipping track number for 7 days to make sure it has arrived. Our guaranteed delivery is 7 to 10 days, but we said 7 days should be enough. So the first batch of people, sometime today, tomorrow, early next week, should receive your units. Please, when you receive your units, as you have received it, inform us. I've received my one little email. Go back to the Keshe Foundation, where there is to do with the units, and just inform us, I received my units with a tracking number. This is important for us because there is a huge structure to set up. We are going for not only the power units, we are delivering from the same factory the pens, we are delivering the pads, we are delivering all sorts of things, something like 10 different components within the next few weeks will deliver the factory. So we need to get tracking back that we know our operation. And the only way it comes, not by them telling us we delivered it, let's say we never received it, is by you informing us, and if there is any problem, we open up a line called customers or whatever, they're going to announce it, then you get the response back, we can tie up the ends. The car units are the first units which have left. The energy units are the second batch which is left. We had to modify things even in the last minute of the production to make sure everything is in order. The car units which you receive carry a very heavy duty cable. The ones you get for the battery operation. The connection is done inside the unit. What we've done is, I'm looking for a pen, and I forgot I don't use color pens anymore. So what you have two heavy duty cables coming out where the connections have been made inside the box in the formation we should be. So when you receive it, go back on the foundation website about the connection. One goes to your whatever you want to connect it. These are plain cut wires. You have to strip them and put them where you want them. If you want it to be part of your battery, you want to have an addition, put it somewhere else. So if I remember, it's a standard blue and brown cable. So you connect it. The cables are about 1.5 meter, I think, plus long, that you can find a position anywhere in the car for them. It doesn't tie you up to one place. You can put it in a boot and bring it forward. Everything has been foreseen that way. There are very high tension cables. So you decide where and how you do it. We advise you, if you don't understand about these things, go to a car mechanic and just say, connect these two ends, understand which end is which end. The manual should tell you that where you have to connect, what to where, which one is positive, which one is negative. The color is explanatory international level. So when you save units, I'm pretty sure some of you should receive it this morning because they've been shipped before. We kept silent, but some people should receive the first unit. If you receive it, please just go back on the foundation and inform the customer services you received your units. We know where it's going, the way it is. And all your energy units, we will fulfill all our commitments, whatever is being paid for and not cancelled, hopefully within the next 7 days maximum. But you have to tell us when you receive them. If there is any need for changes, we'll let you know. And as you understand, you're part of a developing technology. We work together to find the solutions in different ways. There are possibilities, as I said, we have developed a new battery operation. We will market the battery operation. It will fit more or less, we're trying to get it fitted more or less to a battery like this for 9 volt. And it will last, we don't know, a few years. Does not need recharging, and it will recharge itself automatically, continuously. It doesn't need a breathing space of a day or two or a few hours to recharge, because it works totally different way. It's a continuous production, and the 1.5 volt batteries should follow in the same manner. The energy supplies, as I explained yesterday, I was in a meeting with some industrialists in Rome, and the biggest concern they have, the industrialists, is what's going to happen to the structure of the economy of Italy with these units. This is the biggest concern. What is an Italian government at highest level are focusing on what we've done. It's a sword which cuts both ways. We are creating huge number of jobs in coming weeks as we are now going into mass production. But what I explained to the industrials and the government is very simple. We do not have a choice. We have a new energy system fuel in the market. The only difference with this fuel is non-nuclear, and every man can produce it themselves. This is one of the biggest now we see here, because we are part of the structure. We had, as I explained, you had the oil, we had the coal, as we found coal, we used coal, we went to oil, now we're going to solar, what do you call it, panels. Now, this is a new fuel. The governments and people have adapted themselves in how to use the new fuel. You could not get a, what do you call it, a coal and put it in your car and hope to drive with the coal. We tested it, we've done the, what do you call it, steam trains and the rest of it. We have, it's a position, it's a change of science. So we have to understand how we're going to adapt ourselves using these new technologies. I was even discussing it this morning and yesterday. We are developing new tools, new systems which uses plasma. So plasma heaters, plasma cookers, plasma everything else. Because one of the things I think, Vince, you have to put this on the website regarding the Magrav system. You have to watch your washing machines. This is what we're looking at in the factory on Monday. Your washing machines, you have a heating element in it. Do not connect your washing machines to the line directly till after 2-3 weeks. Do not. Be careful when you put your washing machines on. The microwave convection ovens. These are the things you don't try to keep out. After 2-3 weeks, slowly when the power sets in, then start using them normally. Because most of the washing machines take cold water and boil it to the temperature it needs. It heats the water up. So you have a resistor inside. We are looking into providing a resisting system. We have seen it. It can be done. There is a possibility we can do it. As I explained to you, with the new adapters, which they sit like this. Yesterday, on Monday, we were looking at it in the factory. The first prototype should be on the table in the next couple of weeks. So where we, you have your, for example, Italian three plugs here. You have the normal three holes inside. And we build a system here that the three holes you have more or less sits on top of it, if you look at it that way. So it'll be a system like this. We show the prototype, the first prototype in the next couple of weeks. That you take the adapter and you plug it in. This adapter, we think, at its moment of work, can allow a resistive unit, as we explained before, to be connected to the system. There is a guy who we hear has posted that he's managed to produce the system 5.4 kilowatt. It's the first confirmation independently. And we get other people who are now start building their system correctly, will do the same, and we get it posted. The systems are in operation, and we have received the huge orders for delivery by the companies who are in energy industry. They have already checked, they are working with it. I was in a meeting with them in the past couple of days, and they want the system to be applied immediately in hospitals. Because most of the system in hospitals are on a non-resistive, and one of the biggest expenses to run hospitals is electricity. Most of them are on saving light system, and the system can immediately, literally, bring all the major part of the expenses of the electricity in the hospitals, keeping the machinery which are non-resistive, and systems which are, what do you call it, the lighting system. So the first commercial order we received is to go to a number of hospitals to reduce the bill. The order was placed yesterday, I accepted the order, and so they are fully aware, they've studied it, and we'll see where we go to the next phase. The industrial application of the technology is huge. The saving on present use of oil and coal is going to be huge. Calculation, what was shown by the people who are looking into it, they are estimating a saving in the places where it is non-resistive, because what they looked at it, what they explained, is that the systems, like in Italy, you have most of the world the same. You have your plug system, which you plug in like the resistors, transistors, and the rest. You have a light circuit in the, like in the hospitals, and then you have a system which is connected to heavy usage machinery like a heaters or what do you call it, the support section. What they see is these units can be connected to the line of the lighting and the plugs. And one of the biggest problem is guaranteeing the supply continuously, that if there is a shutdown, the system does not shut down. So we're going into the next phase of generation of the system, and we'll see what the next steps bring. So these units, the standard units, is going to be tested for these two, where they can isolate the heating elements. And by the time they use, what the idea is, by the time they use these systems and we know the reverse coating of the capability of the system, they think this system will be nano-coated in time that they can use it in conjunction with all the systems. In next week, by the end of next week, as we promised to the Italian police force, we delivered the first car units to the Italian police force. Because again, it's part of the major expenses of any police force is the fuel cost. They cut from monitoring, they cut from policing, because they have to pay for the fuel. This way, with the systems, we pay for it to be installed with the police force here in Italy. I have met them, and what we'll do, we monitor the fuel consumption. Yes. You gotta wait. You need my microphone. Has it got still a battery in it? Yes. You are. You can speak.
Okay, my question is about the nano coating process of the coils. And may I draw on the.
Yes. Cause you're lucky you're here. Otherwise, you need a very long arm to get here from the United States.
Okay, so I start from the drill.
Yeah.
This is my drill. And this is my coil. So the drill goes counterclockwise. So my coil starts, let's say, from here and goes like this. Okay, I have two coils. I have one, which is the bigger one. And one, which is the smaller one, we call it gravitational. Both are in the same direction. So, from my understanding, okay, let's say this is the in and this is the out. The in and the out.
Yeah.
Out. Okay, when I nano coat these coils, let's see. This is the in,
yeah,
and this is the out.
No, this is the out. This is the in, this is the out.
Okay, but I have these two.
Yeah, but so that's the in of the magnetical and that's the out of the magnetical.
Okay, so this part is the in,
yeah,
of both.
Yeah.
And this part is the out of both.
Yeah.
But the direction change because in this coil, I move clockwise.
That's why, yes.
And this coil, I move counterclockwise.
Yeah, that's the field movement, not yours.
That's
the field. It's two different things.
Okay. So, when I coat my coil, my understanding is I have to apply a voltage, millivolts, for to give directions.
You don't need to. You just put it in a caustic and you can do it.
Okay. Because my understanding, well, what I'm doing at the moment is applying. Just because in my multimeter, the electrons move from the minus to the plus, I'm applying here the minus and here the plus.
Yeah, and here the minus. Quoting, not Gans nano quoting.
And here the plus.
No, you are Gans quoting or your nano, your electric quoting.
No, I'm quoting with a caustic. But when I make my coil dry, no. I apply a minus.
You carry the same proposition, still minus, still plus.
Same.
The same.
Doesn't matter if in one coil the direction. Okay.
No. So you nano coat it the same way, and you place it in the same way. When you're going to get your coil, is the flow which counts, not the matter.
Yes.
So if you change it, you create an opposition, and then your system doesn't work. You have losses.
Wow.
You understand?
Okay.
So this in a way goes, if you do it that way, this goes this way, this goes that way, you create an obstruction in the field level. And then that drops your energy, that drops high, high. So okay. This drops your energy level. Good morning. So, we have more people here. Good morning. Hi. You are from Romania?
Yes.
You've been teaching yesterday or on Monday?
Yes.
Ah, nice. Welcome. Yeah. Welcome. Hello. Please sit down. Join us in the front. So, you see the understanding, good morning. The understanding is the connection where you create a flux flow. If you create an opposition, you create a crash, you create reduction, whatever, which one is stronger, overtakes. So you're left with crumbs. I don't know why, we apply current in the factory in a way. What we do in the production is that we use a 100 degree caustic. We keep the caustic constantly at 100 degrees. And we apply a very low current through the bars, through the coils, on a constant basis in the same flow. Because we cannot wait to boil water or whatever. The production facility is set up. Don't forget, in a factory, we are targeting 100,000 units a day. This is a target in the next few 2 or 3 months. So, and it's a new technology, so we are finding the parameters, new parameters. 10,000 units next week when it goes into, actually, next week goes into production. Those 10,000 units should come. We're looking, because it's a commercial proposition, we are looking 100 units per person per day. So everything has to be made so simple that it's just a production facility. Every 5 minutes, a unit should be out of the premises from the time. But don't forget, we look at every option. A new, this morning, I released, good morning. Another color. Oh, they can't see it. There is a new capacitor setting which this morning it goes into the application, because when you have four capacitors, plasma capacitors in the circuit, you have all sorts of problems, especially when one of your ends of the capacitors is just a piece of wire and then you have a coil. Yeah. So this wire has no connection anywhere, and it slides in and out. So we devised for a faster production, starting from today, the units which go out, we've developed. I worked on it yesterday, and it's the easiest way. We just get a plastic cross. You've seen it, you use it in a construction industry. You have these bars, which are like a cross, they use it for tiling or whatever. And when you look at the tiles, all we do is we place a capacitors, four capacitors. So what you look at it is like this. Oh, sorry. When you look in your production, when you look at it, you see it. If you, I've never been good in drawing, but I show it for you here this way. If you, this is a top view, you see four springs. The side view, you see this. You have two coils on either side and coils on the other side. So what do? We connect the four coils up and the four coils down, and with one like a heat resistance paper, you just encircle it, your four springs, capacity unit stays the same, and what you have literally is like this. You have four units connected on top, you twist it, and four connected down, you twist it. These are your capacity units. You can put one parallel with your stacker, and you put one parallel with your entrance. So now we have the capacity unit. Three, four people can produce thousands a day. All you need to do is just put a tape connecting the top and the bottom. So this never moves out, and there is no possibility of a breakage. This is simple solutions we see, and because I know a lot of people are going into manufacturing, these are the things you have to watch to ease the production. Otherwise, you start making single capacitors, you try to tie them up to the other ends, and then moves, and if something happens, the pin comes out, you lose your capacitance. This way, everything, a capacitor unit, four capacitors, is a part of the mass production, because I know a lot of people are looking into go to production. You should know this, makes life much easier to market the technology. It's a plastic, it doesn't matter, it's a nanomaterial, they're already insulated. It's just finding a facility to be able to be practical in production. At the moment, you have four capacitors lying next to each other like this, separated by material, and then the pin can move out. This doesn't allow any movement. It's one pack, it's a capacitor pack. So most probably in the next few weeks, we'll make caskets of four capacitors inside and this production unit. And all we need to do is to make it in a way that it fits into the framework. Pardon? Yes, we try, but it's impossible. It's very difficult to do it, but it's got to be done, or we make the end as one bend, because now they behave as one unit. Because it's this bend at the end which connects to the stacker or to the power supply. There is something else, if you use thermal resistance units to stop the heating. If you have a heating in your system, you have the two lines from the grid. You use your phase line. You connect your phase line to your thermal resistor unit. It's a plug-in. You plug it in, and then on the other end of the thermal resistor, you use a normal wire and connect your the capacitors or your stacker unit at this point. You do all the matter state work before you come into the unit, before you bring these resistor units or capacitor units into operation here in parallel. You place your heat thermostats before the system. These are little things which help you very rapidly. As I said, we're targeting up to 10,000, 30,000 a day. So we are seeing it. The capacity, potential capacity in Italy is around about anything about 300 to 400 million in the next 12 months. We cannot meet it. We already asked other people to collaborate with us to increase the production. It's unlimited. If we achieve the battery units, if we achieve the new heating system using plasma, these all have to be manufactured in each nation. The job opportunity is huge. As I was explaining before we start, we've seen a positive move by the Italian government in supporting mass production, employment opportunities through new technology. This is what they've been waiting for. They were waiting for the first units to come out. And now that the first units are out, they're out with full force trying to support us to meet the demand of Italian market and international market for the time being. By us being ahead in production and development, Italy becomes a leading supplier till the other nations come into operation. And we can keep that lead very much. And Keshe Foundation now is an Italian entity as a manufacturing organization, and we are answerable to the Italian nation. Even though I control the majority shareholding on behalf of the Keshe Foundation Italy. The whole concentration with wherever you work is to support your nations, to develop these technologies. Doesn't matter if United States, China, or whatever, share knowledge with us the way we do. Little nitty connections, which improves the system, increases the production. Anything you see on one hand or other has to be applied very rapidly. The problem is not in developing the technology anymore. The problem is how fast we can commercialize it. And today, even though we now employ number of people in the, what do you call it, in Italy now, in the factory, we announced today in the Italian website, only when we do the clear checking, we are looking between at least 3 to 10 people who know, understand how to make nanomaterial, how to make industrial scale in the factory. We want you to be, we employ you. The wage has been set between the agreement between the Keshe Foundation and Italian government, between 35,000 and 50,000 wages per annum. This is official, we announce it today. If you are Italian, you got to be Italian, not to live in Italy. You got to be Italian citizen, Italian, what do you call it, workforce, Italian person, because each nation will support itself. If you've been around Italian Keshe Foundation, you are looking for up to 10 people who can teach our present Italian workforce to understand the work, how nanomaterial it is, what is different than the matter, because in production now we see this gap. They don't understand the principle. We need you to work as a full-time with, I think, 35,000, 50,000 is not a bad wage. Don't forget you pay taxes, you're out of the frame of the donation system of the Keshe Foundation. And we already employ, so I was discussing with Vince this morning before I come in that we are going to put a section, the workforce we need for Italy. So you can check in for job opportunities, how you can work with us. We are looking for Italian researchers here in Italy, and I'm sure the German manufacturing side of the Keshe Foundation will go into operation before end of this week to start recruiting or whatever they do to start their operation. They most probably go into production by Christmas or before Christmas. And the same is with the British and the Americans will be done in the coming days. So, as I said, now we become a workforce in Italy and it has to be the same. If you learn something, share with us. We learn something, we share with you openly. One of the points which will come in the coming days is the production of the second unit of the unit, which I was told don't announce it, but we already told you we are working on a generator unit. The generator unit to be added to this present power unit will employ another 3,000 to 5,000 people in Italy. It's massive because then it changes a lot of things. Then the other point, which is we're looking for the workforce is on the health side and what you call the food unit. These go all after Christmas, we don't have the time for it. But the power production, the energy unit is the full production capabilities. We have grown so much that in the way we see it, and the Italian authorities see it, they are moving us from one factory to another next couple of weeks to be able to meet the demand of Italian nation. It's so advanced. The Italian government and authorities are embracing the new technology. We moved to a new location, and I was told yesterday negotiations are to move us to a more advanced, that we can employ a large number of people more in the center of Italy than where we were on the boundaries. So we have received a full cooperation. And if you're setting up the Keshe Foundation, you can ask for our units. We give you your units. You can show to your authorities what it's going to do and what it is. And because it creates jobs, most of the nations will support you. Most of your governments will support you because you become a new generation of the employment groups by the back of your own technology. You have developed it collectively, and now you deserve to use it collectively. Are there any questions? Not as far as we've seen. People have been using the systems in conjunction with their computers at home, no. Don't forget, the computers work on a DC, and plasma is DC, so it's within its operation. The only time you will see what we said, like in a resistive mode, is where you have to introduce the system very slowly to allow the heating elements to be nano-coated very slowly. Let me explain to you why you will have failure in resistive units. The failure, I explained this before, with the resistive units is that this is your the heating element, the bars, which is commonly used to heat. Your nano coating from your unit, your plasma coming, they start nano coating this. What it does, it starts nano coating. And then, what are you going to get? Is this. The resistive power of the bar, when it's nano-coated, we've seen this 7-8 years ago, is that the nano-coating stays more or less cool. The more it gets nano-coated, the cooler it gets. But the resistive inside gets hotter, and it has no way to release its energy. So what happened? Somewhere here, you get a meltdown. When you switch it off, if you nano-coat it very finely, if you allow nano-coating to happen, not rapidly, over time, what happens is that the nano-coating should be able to allow to happen so slowly in this, in these layers, that the, even if the heater of the, what you call the heating element melts, the nanomaterial cascades it. The only problem is left is how you transfer the heated element inside, the heater with outside. This is where the problem with the resistive units will come. The nano-coating of the system will run and cascade the copper wire. And your copper wires have a limit. And then because they cannot, due to the nano-layering, because of its darkness or its blackness absorbing all the energy, not only you're absorbing the material energy this way, you absorb the energy coming out too. It's blanketing. And your wire heats up, and then it melts. But in melting in one point or the other, if the nano-coating is done perfectly, then it allows the next process, which you think is the heat transfer, to take place because of the high volume of the heat. The next generation of the heating elements, which will come with the plasma, it's very, very simple. We introduce heat transfer interaction between different layers. It's a totally different technology. And then this allows you to release the heat in the environment. What you do, if you are in research and you can support it, or you can look further into it, is very much like this. You got to look for a new development. And that development is very simple. You have to create we still have a bunch of people. It's a holiday time. Just 1 second, please. Susa. Yes, just about 11, 11:30. He has to go.
He has to go
from here. 11:30, you stop.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Yeah. What you got to look into develop, what is a part of the equipment technology development, has to be a system like this. You should find a system which, let's say, you nano-coat or you create a GANS plasma from, let's say, copper oxide plus aluminium oxide. And then you create another plasma condition of, let's say, aluminium oxide. The transfer of the plasma energy from one to another, in interaction of the plasma here, should lead to interaction of the magnetic gravitational field, exactly like the upper atmosphere and the sun. This heat release, if it can be used, then you create a new heating system. You should be able to create two type of plasmas, which is one weaker than the other, and in transportation from one to another, in a gradient difference, somewhere here leads to this heating of the environment. It's the dynamism of it. It's a dynamic plasma. You can do possibility of using oscillation, two separate different kind of oscillation of the plasma, that it'll never catch up and it's constant, and the rate of oscillation changes the rate of heating. These are the new equipments which we have to look for. Maybe the way I see it, less than maybe 5 or 10 euro to produce a system. It's understanding the transportation of magnetic gravitational fields. The other system which you're looking for is plasma heaters for cooking. You use microwaves, now you have to use a plasma at a given point to deliver the temperature for cooking. So what we are looking for is very much the same thing, but centralized to a point that it can release energy at a given point using plasma interaction. When we solve these two, maybe in the next few weeks or few months, then you introduce this as new plasma energy, which connects directly to your power units, and there is no possibilities of breakdown. At the moment, even when you use 5.4 kilowatt, you're talking in an electron vibration level. Now we have to go into the plasma vibration. And it's safe, it's a standard, it takes what it needs, and what you need to do, most probably the time of what you call cooking will come to a few seconds. Within a minute, anything you want to cook is cooked. Because you decide the strength of the plasma and understanding that even, let's say, if you're cooking beef, beef itself in a state of gas, when you interfere with its plasma state, it opens up. The separation of the plasma of the gas of the meat makes it soft. That's why we eat it. So we instantaneously add plasma to the matter at the level we need. So cooking time, spending hours in the kitchen becomes history. It's not the microwave, it's the plasma transformation. If you understand this work, that's what I said, there is so much still to be taught and a lot still to be developed. Hundreds of years of what man has achieved, developing different type of cooking, making things. Now, when we rethink about it, we work, we understand the interaction of the plasma in electrical, in matter state, in the plasma state, we can do huge number of jobs. One of the things for the industrialist, if you're looking for melting, for example, in the furnaces, you don't need to do this anymore. Melting can be done, industrial melting in a large quantity can be done literally by creating, understanding the magnetic field, the structure of the lesser iron. You have iron ore, you know the temperature. You know the temperature is a confirmation of the strength of the gravitational magnetic field. You produce it the same way as you produce nanomaterials by the separation from matter. Now you create a molten condition. Total cost less than, I think, $1, $2, if you understand how you do it. The other thing is extraction. The new systems you have to work for, there are millions of you not there. You are waiting for the energy unit, it's in a plasma condition. As I said to you before, the unit has one thing, connects to the grid, and the other end is a power supply in a plasma state. It's you who's changing it to the electron vibration to heat up or run your computer. If you start changing the state of mind in using the power of the plasma, then you see the opportunities changes. The lighting system, the electronic system, the extraction units, what you use, do we need to dig so much deep in the mines to extract copper? Not really, because now that we understand the strength of this plasma and we can dictate its strength, all you need to do, you need to create continuous gravitational magnetic field of the copper. And what happens? Anywhere underground, there is atomic or molecular copper, it gets attracted. We've done this test. This test was done about 4 years ago. It works. It's just industrializing it. You have the same thing as a poison. You find the gravitational magnetic field of the poison, and all you need to do, you make a copy of it, and it's extracted. The burning, the melting, the extraction by different means is totally finished. Once we start developing these technologies, it's so much to do. As I said, the greatest problem for human race was to discover a technology where it works the way the universe works. That's your biggest problem. In a paper I've written somewhere, I cannot find it, I was looking for it, if I can remember where it is, something which explains the origin of the heating of the planet. how Earth is part of the book number four. How you create the heating. Why the heating is only surface deep at the layer. The reason for this is important if you people understand who work with the heating elements, because part of the division of the Keshe Foundation, the organization we work with, they are only in heating emergency heaters for the homes. That's one of the reasons we merged the companies, was that they were looking for a free energy for their new energy heaters, and we could understand the other way. But to understand how do you create heat, why the heat is only a few meters from this planet. We saw this in a very simple way. If you look at the Earth, Earth creates gravitational magnetic field in a plasma state. The environment around the Earth is the plasma state too, our atmosphere. Where does the heating come from? The heating comes only by at the point of the matter state, just on the surface. The heating inside the Earth is due to this process. It's two different heating. The heating inside the Earth is due to interaction of gravitational magnetic field forces, which in interaction of different plasmas, what we call lava, and the central field materials create the heating. But the heating on the surface of the Earth and all the planets, where here is your solid state, just a tiny surface, is at a point where gravitational magnetic field of the center, in the interaction with the gravitational field of the atmosphere, with the separation of the matter state, which creates the heating. It's the Earth solid layer interaction which creates the heating. And nothing else. It's the plasma inside coming out in the interaction with the plasma, which is the atmospheric plasma, and at the point of the interface is where your heating takes place. The difference is so much that it needs, was it 10,000, 4,000, whatever meters for the heating to be at the temperature we can live at 5 or 10 or 20 degrees. Because the temperature inside, or what I call the magnetic field strength inside, does not change. So the surface doesn't change either here. The only thing changes is the strength of the plasma, which is the plasma of the sun, as it interacts, it decides if it's 100 degrees or 20 degrees or 50 degrees. You got to understand the difference. And if you understand this, it should be very easy for most of you to create a very simple system. A coil, nano-coated with a gas on it, then add a matter state, like an aluminium foil, and then put another, another coil outside it. If you get the ratio of the strength the right way, you made yourself a heating element. The problem is the Ganser state of strength and how you do it. You've seen this operation with the beads with Alex. What have you done? You had the, can we get rid of this fly somehow? Where is Armin? Our export catcher is not here today. You put the element inside, you put the GANS, you put the, you put the tissue paper, then you added the have a new foil, and then you added your coil on two ends. If you look without you understanding, you already are doing the same, but you're not getting the ratio right. If you get the ratio right, if you be able to create, understand what you're doing. This is this one here. This one here, the center one, is the center of the Earth. Here, the green is the plasma here, what we call magma. Here is one separation, aluminium foil outside is the layer of the Earth, the solid layer of the Earth. And all you do, you transfer the energy, you take the energy when you slow down. If you can design a system that at this point, you don't take the energy away, but at this point, in respect to create another atmosphere around it, that it releases heat, you have made a plasma system, heat system. It's very easy to make. It's just developing it that we can use it. But the only difference is, what is in our research, is when you're holding this in your hand, or this in your hand, the atmosphere stays the same. The cups, the plates feel the same, but you feel the heat in your blood. You feel the warmth in your blood. People who hold these units in their hands, they tell you, I'm warm. Because the minute you hold with your fingers in your hand, the energy transfer to your hand is through gaseous state. Automatically your body feels warm. Then you can literally connect the wrist to your hand. I want to be at 20 degrees today, warm and nice. You walk around 20 degrees. We've seen this. It's not a theoretical. It's just extending the commercialization of it. The whole place can be at minus 50 degrees. You set your temperature to be at 25 degrees. You feel comfortable. You can do. Because now you transfer energy through gas of the blood and your body. Don't forget, a very near system to this, some 30, 40 years ago, was developed on a chemical process where you could crush the unit. I remember the Iranian police force, night duties at the winter time were supplied with. In a very cold condition, they could crush these units and keep their hands in their pocket, and they were warmed. That was a chemical, they last 4 or 6 hours. This, if you understand how to do it, it lasts your lifetime. We wear a watch. Now we adjust the thermometer, what we want to feel, irrespective of what is outside. This is how you warm yourself in a space. There are no jackets, there are no clothes. You keep yourself warm, your blood condition in the flow, according to the plasma you see. This is what you need to be able to live in a space. From now on, in these blueprints and all the teachings, we start looking for development of new equipment. It's no use coming up with a power supply where you have no energy, no application for it. We got to change the application, but understand what it brings. This, if you can do, but you have to understand this first, how the heating of the elements on this planet comes. Once you understand the heating process, is not by rays of the sun, but is by actual the solid state of the surface and the liquid, which allows the separation of the field strength between the two, which creates the heat on the surface. The internal cannot change, the external is the deposition of the sun to the earth. So you get heated up or not, according to how much resistance is there. Why do we have hotter temperature on the center of the equator line? Why less on the north or the south pole in separate position? So now you understand more or less. And then if you understand this in a more extensive way, you understand one thing which you need in development. Why we have a landmass and water in a given ratio. on this planet? Why do we have different ratios of a land mass and a water? 5 to 1, 7 to 1, depends on what you measure. Because the heating is so much that you need the cooling system, which is the water. Otherwise, the whole land mass would have melted. There is a reason, there is a ratio for why we carry so much liquid. If we don't carry liquid, the amount of energy which is released from the central mass is so much that it will create so much heat on the surface, it will be hundreds of degrees, not as we have it that we can live on it. The cooling system, the conversion, the cooling system, which is the rapid conversion of the plasmas in a soft way, is the oceans. Without the oceans and open seas, this ratio of the transfer of the plasmatic gravitational magnetic field from the center to the outside is impossibilities. It comes to meltdown. So, what you got to look in the blueprints, in the development of new technologies, new tools, are these kind of things. The new heating system for a space. I don't teach you this just to create a cooker or a heating of element, that you can use the technology. You're learning this, that in a space, you can warm yourself with a simple system like your watch. Because you transfer plasmatic energy to blood. We've seen it. People who are developing technologies around the foundation for us in the background, the support team, they, when they pick up these units, they feel the temperature, the heat in their fingers. It's cool, but the blood is warm. They always reported, they couldn't understand it. I had to explain to 2 or 3 of them in the past 2 or 3 weeks. Because the temperature here is created by the gravitational magnetic field, which comes at this point, and because it's plasmatic, when it touches your finger, it transfers to it. So it's plasmatic. You cannot take fair course from Earth to planet Zeus. You have to be able, when you understand this kind of heating system, how this system, because it runs through your blood, you're blue-blooded, you're British. So, that's what they say they are, aren't they? If you're a true British, you're blue-blooded. And if you don't know the reason, I can explain it to you. Do you know why they call them blue-blooded? Let me finish this one, I'll tell you, blue-blood British, they can explain to you why. So, what happened? The plasma transfer is through the circulation of the lymph and the blood, and so you warm up continuously. And by the ratio of the heating, the energy transfer is instantaneous, because you're a vacuum, you are a superconductor. So, you got to see what is to come. As I said, we don't want you to develop a technology or a system for your cooking pot. We are developing a technology without clothing in the space, you can warm up your blood, that you don't freeze. There is no need to wear these funny costume astronaut suits to put hot water in it or cold water in it, or pumping hot water when you go into the deep seas. You're just, these are not theories, these are now working units. It's just commercializing it, it's taking time because there is more important things to carry on. But if any of you can extend this knowledge, put it on the table, we tell you how we've done it, we have achieved it through this combination. Please extend the knowledge, add it and come back to us, or don't be one of those who go to China and come back with everything hidden over the headache. So, put the plasma system into operation, understand it, and use it. You've got to be able to transfer plasma energy, not heating energy of electron vibration. Now, I tell you 1 second, what true, they say the Queen of England is true English woman because she's blue-blooded. As you understand, as you know, English people were so backwards in everything, they didn't have arrows. And when the Vikings came to invade Britain, They had nothing. They had no intelligence of anything. So the only thing they had was a blue paint. They used to paint themselves blue and jump in front of the Vikings. Ah! And they never seen a person, they used to run away because it's like seeing a Martian. And then they said the true British are the ones who used to paint themselves blue, and that blue has gone into their blood. So that's why they call the true British are blue-blooded. They are the people who had no intelligence how to defend us. Color was the only thing they had. They didn't have intelligence to make an arrow to defend themselves. So now that's how you become a true British. So now you see what is needed. Extend the knowledge of development of application. The blueprint weeks will be for development of applications, new tools, new communication tools, infinity communication control lines. Remember, we gave you the coils. You have a double coil. You have a gravitational coil, and then you have a magnetical coil. You have another gravitational coil, and then you have a magnetical coil. Here in the power units, you stacked two of them on top of each other, three of them that way. In the stacker units, you have put your coils like this, and then you stack three of these on top of each other. Now, learn a new technology. This is a control of the plasma. The plasma can be controlled in an infinity loop. Marco has built the first one before Christmas, the unit we showed you. What do you do? You build these two coils, which you put inside each other, and then you build the second coil, which you put on top of it. This is, if I can go back, if I find it, the drawing of the coils. Can I go back here? Wait. Previous page. Yeah. There we came across it somewhere here. Here you put the coils inside each other. A set of two over a set of two. Now learn the next technique. The next technique is a controller plasma. And the controller plasma comes this way. Where is it? I lost my page. Okay. The next technique in your development of plasma comes with this. Take the small unit, a small coil with a double, the same tray as you had. Now, face the two to each other. One, let's put it in ratio that you will learn. If I take this off, and then I add this, make this is your small coil, and the other one is your big coil. Don't forget, you still have the gravitational magnetical combination. Try to remember something which you learned. When you have two plasma, you have the gravitational. Sorry, let me do it a different way that the colors don't confuse you. When you have a plasma, two plasmas, you have the gravitational, and then you have another gravitational. Here you have two magnetical and two magnetical. You see the connection? This is how two magnets find their distance. This is how two magnets find their position, what we call gravitational magnetical positioning. Now that you have two systems together, look at the similarities. This is your control system. You have to develop this in a very strong way with different materials for different strengths. So look what you have. Place this as your two units. That's there. That's there. Where do gravitational connect to magnetical? The gravitational is needed from this to connect to the magnetical from this or this. You have developed the first positioning system with less than 10 cents or a dollar. This is how you control. Now, if you understand this and you can make these systems loose enough, you find the two will move. Or if you can pinpoint them, the field, gravitational magnetic field created here is the magnetic field of the gold, magnetic field of arsenic, or anything you want to do. This is the new control system. You have to develop it because in a space technology, what are you going to do? You need to create a bar in a shape form that you can slide this bar somewhere here. You increase your magnetical, the same field here increases your gravitation. You find positioning through plasma systems, not electronic system. There is no flight, there is no ejection, there is no burning of a fuel. Now you have to start learning how to use these systems for different applications. You need these interactions. Positioning, when you made a stacker of three, you created a energy system. I do it in black. When you made the stack of three, you made an energy system. This is your sun. Now, this is your control system. We showed this control system in the last day of last term here in but in a different way of formation. And then, if you understand this, and you transfer the knowledge into a space technology, you can create lift position. Instantaneous disappearance, instantaneous. You can create a condition of the gravitational magnetic field where if you want, the field strength can be so much that this goes beyond the boundary and your system or your craft becomes totally invisible to the eye of any man. Now you have the knowledge. Now you can make the difference in how to do it. One piece which was missing in your technology, and you have to go. Don't get concentrated. A lot of you are doing the energy. The ones who understood the energy, move on to control. Start developing control system. Bunch of you, thousands of you, start developing the heating system. A lot of you have to move in understanding to transfer of energy in application of food. Because now you see how you can use the coils in a different way to change your coil section in a way. If you change one of these coils set up in a stacker, then you can produce any kind of energy which is emitted from the disk. It could be vitamin C, it could be protein of beef or lamb or whatever you like. Now you can control. There is a possibility, if you understand this, group of you who go into development of the control system, try to take it to the next step. Do not limit your knowledge to only one thing, and that is, I lost it. No, we go back one more. Okay. This is coming up, previous page. Come on, computer. Second one is empty. We go to the third one. Yeah, you're right. So, what happens is that if you go into your stacker, learn something very interesting. What about if you use one of these two stackers here and here as an energy projection and connect this stacker as the control system? You sit in the heart of the control of the plasma. So what happens is these two give you the parameters of both gravitational and magnetical, and this allows you to expand it or reduce it. Expand the magnetical or reduce the gravitational. Now, those who understand have to start running. You thought energy unit was just a way to prove the technology. Now, the energy unit gives you the plasma. As I said to you last week, in the transparent box, we have a plug. And I said, from now on, it's you who decides what comes out of this plug. And if you remember, I put this in front of you. I said, it's you who decides which channel puts what out. Now, to be able to choose the channels, you need to understand this. So, please, those of you who are more into control system, plasma design system, move away from the energy. There are enough people working on the energy or trying to produce energy units, move into control, and then when you move in control, we are moving with you. What I teach you is what we are doing in the background. You're not learning anything which is not getting done. On the development side, we are working on these. So what you see is what we are doing. I want to see how much you come to us to share the knowledge that we can share to develop faster. These control systems are on the table getting tested, and in a way is an addition to the knowledge of the plasma you had. The structure is totally different. The game of the plasma technology has started. Commercialization in a very rapid way. In a way that is so rapid, it'll take most of the human resources to rewrite the history of the science of man. Because now you can act. Now you can act step by step. So please, those of you who've been through the blueprint, you understood it. Now you sort out the winding. Understand we need to go to the next step. The control of the plasma through the structure of the plasma, because now you work through the same process. It's very easy if you remember. I gave you a hint and we explained to you something. Now I go a step further for understanding. If you remember when we showed you the units, put in the center bowls with the gas in it. There is a reason for these center bowls with the gas. The center bowl for the gas is part of your emotion, because it's both gravitational and magnetic field in the center, control of the system through your emotion and thoughts. The present technology, if I take this remote, I hope I don't switch anything off, I have to press a button and wait for electronic interaction. This is obsolete. You cannot work with this with plasma. This is out of date because this is electron vibration. Where now, through, if you understand what to do, through your thoughts, you can increase, you can produce position, you can produce condition, you can increase and decrease gravitational and magnetic fields of one plate in respect to other, increase your shielding or reduce it, or find a new position in the atmosphere. You need this. Interim, this is not a final system. This is an interim system that you go to the next step of development. You have to, you have no choice. Now that we come to this path, we have to complete the development of the control system. We need to complete this development of the energy in a way of heating through plasma and the body of the man, as I always said, is one big sausage. Now you have found how to heat the sausage. This is what is about to come. Now we are developing, I said to you, there are a number of new development technologies getting released, and this is one of them. We already have the system, but now we have to create that we don't boil your blood. But the beauty of it is, you will never boil your blood, because your emotion says, this is the heat I'm comfortable in. You balance it. It's just a matter of giving you this device for you to hold, that can create that feeling, and to get the trust that I'm going to be warm. You know, in America and in Europe, they put the prisoners with a tag on their foot, wherever they go, they can track them. We need a system like this, so small that you just wear it on the body. Maybe in the future development of the human race, in a space, we embed it into our body. That through emotion, we warm the central position, maybe near the heart, that the temperature of the blood circulating keeps constant. Our body already has this thermometer control. Now we can find a physical system and a plasma to do it, but only to be connected with a boundary where the skin of the man is. These are not theoretical, these are not. Now you have the plasma release, you have to apply it. You have to extend the knowledge in a way that allows you to see how new technologies, new systems on the plasma base has to be developed. Very simple. And you all be making the coils. Maybe. You know, when people remove the certain glands in the body, you lose your sleeping time. Yeah. When they remove it, and then they control your sleeping time with tablets. The conditions which they do with the blood temperature. So now we have a practical unit. These things do not need to be copper oxide or copper material. Find new materials, find new GANs combination, find GANs. I refer to this, and a lot of you haven't noticed, I refer to it a few times. If I'm correct. If you look, the answer has been with you, but now that you understand, we can go a step further. But now it makes sense to you, but it's been there. If you go on to the book number 2, The Structure of the Light, I especially put a picture here. There is a picture here that it shows, has it been taken out? Or is it still here? Let me see. Or is it in the paper of the original paper? If it's not here, you can go on the website and download the original picture, where it shows the GANs cannot be mixed. You cannot mix GANs together. What it means is that it's a flat picture. It used to be it's in the original paper of the GANs, is in there. You can see it, I hope. If not, we're taking a close picture of it. Let me see if I can find it. This is important because I explained to you why it's important.
Rick, do you know what picture he's talking about?
It's layers of GANs. The GANs at the end of the bottle, it shows in blue and green.
Chris says page 113.
1130. That's book 2nd edition. I have the 1st edition. Let me explain to you understand it. Here, you're looking for different materials. Yeah. But if you look at that picture in the book or in the paper, you see you don't need this. If you use the right ratio of ganses, the ganses themselves create their own layers. They create their own separation through gravitational magnetic field. They create their own possibilities. So you don't need to look into copper or in the matter state. Look into the GANs and how they separate each other. I especially put that picture in, maybe I'll find it in the papers on the original paper. Because when you see it, we have said that the GANs materials never mix. And you see it, that there are different layers of it. You have to extend the knowledge to develop new GANs, not only copper oxide or a CO2. You have to go to a level that you can create the gradient for the transfer of gravitational magnetic field from one layer to another. You got to realize, extend the knowledge in a further deeper way, where you need to do this, where you move away from these two rings and you work with the superimposed ganses on top of each other. Rick and somebody else in those transparent balls, when we showed it originally, were working on it. Where we saw the water and we saw different layers of the ganses. And I kept on telling you, all of your system is ready to fly. Now you understand. Find a way to tap into the layers and then use the energy difference transfer for plasma release. So the knowledge what you learned from the beginning in the coils, in nano coating, in spherical balls, now is coming together. We cannot keep on producing coils like this. You have to go back to the realistic operation. This is the coils you have. In coils, has anybody seen a coil in a space? I haven't. And I'm sure NASA cannot show a single page of a coil system. You have to understand, now that you see the how the gravitational and magnetical can be embedded and used, go back to the core. And then understand how you can create the layers enough that they can hold on to each other. And then tap into energy. It's gigawatts. It's not any more watts. You're dealing with mega megawatts of plasmatic energy, not electron energy. Start extending the knowledge. Start applying the knowledge, but stand back and look at the totality. This is what I said. The world of science should be divided between nuclear physicists and cosmologists. Then they can open the mystery of the universe. So this is what you got to do. See how the interactions come in, what tools you have. If you need the interim copper nano-coated, aluminum nano-coated too. But understand the ultimate goal now is this, because now you have nanomaterial, you have the GANs to make the beads, you have the plasma technology, and you have a free plasma condition, which is a source. Start developing tools for the application.
Mr. Keshe?
Yes.
I think I found the picture, and thank you to Alan. Can you just check in your book? It's page 79, figure 40.
In the first publication or second?
Yes, that's the publication you have there.
79. I have nothing on my first 79. It's No pictures.
Is that the second revision?
No, this is the first edition. It's a tilted. It's a tilted tube. I remember being there, and I've written about it.
Well, I said they're 113 in
yes,
the structure of the light. Right.
I didn't go that far. You're 100% correct. If you look at the bottom of the page here, the last picture, you see the separation of the ganses. Read what it says. I'll just read you a paragraph. Here, parallel with development and extraction of GANs, these systems produce energy, which are not due to burning of fuel or chemical conversion like in battery. The energy produced during the process of GANs from any system, which this energy can be used for any purpose, this being creation of gravitational field forces to create static sources for creation of Magrav, power to run motors or light up a lamp. This new source of energy needs a clear and new name classification. So, if you look, the paragraph reads on the page 112, says, through experiment and deliberate mixing of different GANs in one solution, it is clear that these materials do not mix or do not chemically interact with each other, where each GAN of each matter stays separated from other matters within the solution and stays the original GANs. Picture number 40 shows a mixture of three GANs in the solution where they stay without any chemical binding, where, for example, a green residual settles can be seen at the bottom of the tube. You see, the green is separated from the brown and the green. The lighter green, and you see a light shadow. And when you look at it, when you shake it, they always stay separate. So when you start mixing GANs together, understand what strength it is. This goes back to the teaching of last term, where we explain in a very simple way the copper oxide or a copper is not 59 or 60, is 49 or 50. Then you find another material, which is, let's say, 39. You don't look at the atomic mass anymore. Atomic mass is for matter state. You look at 30%, 25% gravitational magnetic field mass. Then you'll find very new materials on the strength, which they will float on top of each other. They're stuck like pancake. And then you can tap into different energies from different sources. You want a higher difference, you want a more powerful system, you go to do these two layers. You want a less powerful, you go there. You want very weak, you go to those two. Instead of tapping into different layers of heat, you tap into different strength of the plasma, and then you amplify it in plasmatic, not in electronic, because then you see nothing. Because electronics to create the plasma is too difficult. It just bypasses, overrides it. So you got to learn to produce systems which work totally on the plasma condition. So now you see the world of the knowledge of the universe is totally different than one man has done on this planet using matter state. You have to develop. You have no choice. The cat is out of the bag. The nations and the scientists who develop this technology and understand it will benefit by it and brings a lot of benefit to humanity. It's just to do it the right way that it creates with a little change. We haven't changed anything. Now, part of the teaching of past 2 years, you see how simple it comes together, has a different meaning. You made the coils. Is it 11:30? Yeah, 12. Excuse me, I'm going to give the floor to Marco or anybody else for a bit. I have to meet with some Romanian scientists who are here and they have to leave. They have a flight to catch and I'll come back on again.
Mr. Keshe?
Yes.
We did have Curl Lee in here from the Keshe Foundation in China, and I think he has to show.
Just 2 minutes. What does he want to show? Just 1 minute, please.
Okay, thank you.
Just 1 minute, please. Carl, can you share the screen, please, there? Carl, are you there?
I don't see him now. I think he dropped out for a moment. Did you want to meet and then I'll get try to get Carl back in here?
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Just let me go. Marco will take over till I meet with this gentleman because they have to leave. They've been here for 3 days, but I've been away. One of them taught you on Monday, so
yours. I told you you're going to teach you. You thought you walked away, but just put a, I don't know, Jewish cap on.
Okay. So, time for questions.
Rick, can you hear him?
Hello. Yeah, are there any questions or? I was not following yesterday's discussion here. So.
Oh, okay. 那个这个有谁？
Carl, okay. Yeah, maybe Carl can share.
进。 Hello, Mr. Keshe.
Mr. Keshe is not here at the moment, but...
Okay, I have something to show. And I am having the system running now, the energy plasmatic system. You can see?
Okay.
Yes. Yes, so the two loads, the little fans and the reactor is using this energy of the system right now. And I have made a coil, another coil, and it looks blue and red, you can see, yeah.
Yes.
So I want to ask if this composite layering could increase the potency of the system.
Yeah, with different coatings, you have potential difference between two coils, so you create a field flow between them.
Okay, thank you. And I have another two of these. Can you see? I use this as a auxiliary unit, so I connected this moon units with the planet units together to nano coat all my room. I have four room here. So I have made another three of them. And they are all crosswise. So I still can set them together as one planet unit. So this cell is anti-chloride, and I have another setup, chloride. So I want to know if this curve right there will work or not. Hello, yeah. Marco.
Yeah, try it. What's the difference? With counterclockwise direction of the coils, you actually you create more resistance in the field flow. So you're not adding to the field, you create like interaction of the fields. So it depends what you want to do with this. If you want to achieve lower field strength, maybe that's the way you can do it.
Maybe I can still increase the depth of the system running now and create a higher order of plasma and make a small plasma and the field interaction of the two to create light. Can I achieve this with this idea?
Could be also this, if you were following today's teaching of Mr. Keshe, he was explaining how to control the plasma, how you can increase or decrease magnetical or gravitational field. So there are different.
So I need to connect these two together and as a control system.
Yes.
Okay.
You can use like a middle plate, middle layer for control, or you can use two middle layers for control of the plasma. So it depends how you connect them.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. And how do you think of the triple spring in circle each one another? So I get a triple unit. This is double unit. Can I make a triple unit for potency increasing?
I don't understand. Cheaper unit.
Triple unit is a three spring in circle one another. So I can draw a picture.
A triple unit, Marco.
Yeah,
not a double unit, a triple unit.
Yeah, I want to make a triple unit for increasing the potency.
Carl, you can try everything what's in your mind. It's a new
Yeah. So okay,
you
thank you.
Show it next time, you know, what you want to do and try to understand each coils that you have, each stacker that you have, you can use a middle coil and outside the coil because they both have gravitational and magnetic. So two of them.
And this stacker. Maybe do you have any other right how to mount this stacker on my flat bar?
Yeah, we just lost his connection. Just hold on a moment to see if he comes back.
On our side or
no.
Okay.
It's on his side.
We lost the connection.
Yeah, I think we completely lost the connection.
But we have connection, just the Carl Lille connection.
That's right.
Yeah. No, Fabio Wolf.
Is there anything we want to show at KFSSI while we have that video up? any other questions while we get Curly back?
Hello?
Yep. Hello?
Max, I could show you an example of what Mr. Keshe said before of the non-mixing of guns, if you like to see.
Okay,
that.
We can quickly have a look at that, sure.
Okay, hello everybody. So, can you see?
Yes.
I hold it up. This is, you can see at the bottom, there are two types of GANs. I made once an experience. I surrounded a magnet, neodymium magnet, with nano-coated copper wire. And at the end of the magnets, I put some iron. And all into the salt water, and that's what I collected. These two different type of guns. It looks like, I don't know, at the bottom, I can't say what it is. The other looks like CH3. I don't know. Maybe somebody has an idea what it is.
You have to see what the combination of materials we put in the water. So we have combination of bands now.
Well, what I know is iron surrounded the magnets and the neodymium magnet itself. So
and copper.
Well, the copper around the around the magnets. Yeah.
So you already named it three materials. Then consider that you have some CO2 in there. Two.
Yeah, what do you think is that? These two, this looks like two type of GANs.
Mix of GANs. And it's a new technology. All we have to look deeper to understand it more deeper.
Okay. No. So I have to give to the lab or laboratory to find out what it is, huh? Probably.
Not type of coil, yes. If you understand exactly what materials we put to produce in the gas, so we have all that materials include and whatever we can absorb from atmosphere.
Yeah. I want just to show what Mr. Keshe said, that it really separates the different gain, do not mix. Because I collected this one in from a box, you know, and then it separated again after a while. Okay, that's what it was, sir. Fine. Okay, it's good. We stop here.
Yeah, I'm here. What was the one was whitish? And the other one was reddish, that one that you showed.
It was whitish, and the other one was all reddish brown. Like similar like the one which, the CH3.
Yeah, could be something, mixture of CO2 and CH.
No.
Depends what the materials you were using inside.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, once you have different guns, you have a potential difference between these guns materials, and you have to get this field flow between these layers and then try to use it in our reactors and maybe increase field strength or decrease field strength, or we have to find a control of the of different field strengths out of these materials so that we create, let's say, magnetic gravitational field of certain material, like let's say plastic or gold, and so that we can use it for attraction of plastic maybe, or attraction of gold. But we have to find the right combination of these guns. That's what we have to do.
We can actually create a calculator for that, Marco. If you know our computer guys, they can create a small program for that. That you can calculate the mass of plasma and mass of your atomic weight. It's calculation like 25-30% less.
Yes. But we have to consider also that it's not always like 10-20% less. It's also sometimes 50% less. Let's say with hydrogen, is instead of calculating one, we are calculating 0.5.
0.5, correct. No, we have to consider that and create that easy for people to just input the material and they have their, you know, plasmatic atomic weight, whatever.
Yeah. Actually, database should be created out of these GANS materials, but to consider magnetic gravitational field strength, not the mass of the GANS.
Actually, they can calculate both.
Even better if you have both, yeah.
We have to create new tools.
In some of the teaching in previous term, we were discussing about this, how we get field strength of carbon inside of CO2 kits, or how we get field strength of CH3 inside CO2 kit with different materials inside. So maybe we can go in this explanation once more for general public. In private teaching, we were discussing this once again a few weeks ago, I remember. Or are there any other questions? Any open questions?
We should talk. I'd like to maybe discuss in the stacker, the little plasma balls, the three separate plasma balls. That seems to be the crux of the control of everything on that board right there. That's everybody see that? That's, there's so much stuff right there.
You mean this ones?
Yeah, I think the crux of it in the stacker units, you put the little golf ball size, a little tiny, that's what you control through your thoughts, right? Which controls the other to the left, where you can control positioning and take that, extract it up to the top on the left there. That's your, you can create any materials there. There's and it's all controlled through the three golf ball size plasma fields in your stacker. That's the part you should be able to control mentally. Does anybody else follow? Is anybody else on that track at all?
Yeah, that was the idea that Mr. Keshe wanted to explain to us.
Yeah, it looks like the crux of the control is in the plasma balls in your stackers, which the which is somehow related to you. Now, is it just through the CO2, or is there something that we can align ourselves with or associate ourselves with those particular three plasma balls that we can control through our emotions better?
I think
they're exactly the same, or are they three slightly different? If I'm going to create more gravitational or more magnetical through emotion, are the three plasma golf balls in the center the same or slightly different?
You can put a mixture of GANs, or you can have CO2 on the top, CH3 in the middle, and Cu in the bottom. Then you have your
emotional range.
Yes, your amino acid. So you are
okay.
You are in connection, actually. Or you can put mixture of GANs in all three.
Okay, now it was mentioned earlier that there's a big caution to go along with that. So I think we should, for either control of your mind through a backfeed or
it's an emotion that you are already connected if you have mm-hmm. three composite GANs together. As we learned all the time about Cu and CO2 and CH3. Always in three layers, it depends. You can put separate or you can mix the GAN together and they separate themselves.
Mm-hmm.
You can add, Marco.
Yeah, we have to remember that also our emotions or even our thoughts are magnetic gravitational field based. So they exist. We are aware of them. We feel them, but they are not visible to us. So they are here. There are fields, and these fields interacts with these fields of our emotion, of our thoughts, interact with the environment. So they interact also with the GANs inside this let's say power unit that we are building at the moment. And we have different emotions love, happiness, sadness, and all other different state of emotions, hate, whatever. So somehow we have to understand what we call them, like positive and negative emotions. But this is from our point of view. Some of these emotions are positive to us, but could be negative for somebody else. So this is very relative. We cannot say it's just positive, negative. So for some entity, what is negative emotion for us could be positive for some other entity. So what to release, let's say what we release, emotion that we release, release some magnetical fields could be used for somebody else. And I'm trying to think in this direction that we have to learn ourselves how to use these emotions. But not to be attached to the emotions, we have to be detached from the emotions. So we just release fields of certain emotion, but we don't connect these emotions to our body. So that's what we were discussing a lot in private teachings, how to detach ourselves from our emotions. And so let's say if we release special strength of, let's say, happiness, how will we influence these guns in this in the middle of this our reactors of our coils, and what results will we get? So in a way, these units, these systems are alive. They are interacting with environment. They are interacting with our feelings. And we have to learn how to control them with emotions. Which emotion is the right emotion that we can get results out of it? So, Bill, were you thinking in this direction or something else?
No, I was thinking exactly in that direction. I was even trying to extrapolate out to a training aid, or trying to figure out if the emotion was a projected emotion detached from yourself, like an actor. He mentioned that actors would be very good at this.
It's your thought.
With my thought, right?
Because it's gravitational and magnetical. So you have already connection because your body is in a GAN state. That's what we gotta observe, and test ourselves to understand more deeply. But the connection you already understand.
Okay.
Try to think, plasmatic, then it's easy to understand. Matter state, we're just trying to create, certain things because we used to. But fields, when we deal with the fields, it's totally different. That's why it's a combination of your amino acid in that ball that you are already connected. First, it dictates your emotion, what you want. I will come and be happy and don't worry.
This is going to be like talking to my houseplants in the extreme here.
Well, you tell us.
Like a new puppy, I don't know.
You test and you tell us how you feel and what you achieve. That's the point of the teachings, that we try it and we understood. And we teach each other.
Well, this last picture that's on the board here is just, it's got so much in it. It's got...
As Mr. Keshe said, we just opened the plasma technology. So we have to change our understanding too. Slowly but surely.
Yeah, my mind's running off on tangents, so all kinds of ways.
So how you see this picture on the board?
You can see positioning. You can see up the top production of materials. If we're going to stay in the material state here, but you can produce. You looking at that, you should be able to produce whatever material through thinking about it. Over, you know, in your stacker, manifesting it in the relative position of the two fields on the lower left, and then extrapolating up to the top, you can produce a field that would attract your materials that you've literally desired, and you should be able to tune it. You know, you could be, you know, dipping out lead and then switch over to a heavier or lighter element through a slight adjustment. Literally be able to dribble out anything.
Mm-hmm.
Especially if you pass it through like near seawater or something in a big diverse thing to draw from. And then that's still back in the material state. So this is just a stepping stone.
It is. So, you know, what I recommend that each of you create your own combination of them. Your emotions are already in the combat.
See. The hardest thing is what to do first. What's most important?
First, we have to try to understand energy and bring the perfection that everybody understands and uses correctly.
Ah.
Then it's the next step of a control. Then it's the next step of a fly. Then there is no end.
Yeah, literally. It's, yeah.
Maybe the first step too in that direction is to go where your passion is or where your heart leads you in a way. It's got to be fun, or if you're not having fun, you're not doing it right, kind of idea. Like Mr. Keshe's prayer to his reactor, I hope you're going to have as much fun with this as I am. That was one of his
if
prayers.
If your thoughts are in there, it's already, you already transferred. Like, we have to understand it's instant.
Mm-hmm.
It's your emotion, it's already dictated. So that's why it's a very, a crucial point for everybody to make their own systems. Not the coils, you know, or applying the GANs, and because you work with it. It's your emotions all transferred. You're already connected because you did it from the beginning to the end. That's most important, that this knowledge is for everybody, not for one person. And it's easy. We're just trying to convert everything in the matter state. That's why it's difficult. But when you understand, and as Mr. Keshe is saying, detach yourself, you will see totally different. I'm sure of it.
Thank you, Armin.
Thank you.
And let me see, what other questions do we have here? There's Tom Who Knows asks, says, anyone else experienced light orbs while producing GANs? And he mentions a friend sent him a video and so on. He wants comments from Mr. Keshe.
I also experienced something like that in my peripheral vision.
Okay. Maybe he wanted comments from Mr. Keshe. Maybe he would comment on that later when he comes back, possibly. I think he's talked about these orbs recently, actually, in describing different entities that are in the universe as being round, spherical entities were one of them. Here's a question. When connecting the coils to DC, there are two input wires and two output wires. What do you do with the input wires? Leave them open or close them? Two input wires and two output wires.
I don't understand what he's saying.
I'm not sure there either, actually. The coils to DC. He's talking about the car system. I thought there's only the two wires coming from the car system, not two input and two output wires. Perhaps you can clarify the question, Tim. You can rewrite it. Perhaps we can get a better understanding. Candy Parker asks, earlier Mr. Keshe said something about foil over the capacitor. I don't remember hearing that before. Can we put aluminum foil over our capacitors?
No.
Not in this case. That was for the like Alex beads type process. That was different, system. It was a more of a battery than a capacitor, right? Is that true? The aluminum is not to be used with this system. It's just the wrapped wire around the parchment paper type format.
No, you just need to cover that with the plastic or something.
Right, but not with a metallic thing.
There are some kind of plastics that you put on a coil and you just heat it up a little bit and it hugs it very nicely.
Yeah, shrink wrap. People have been using. I don't know what they're called. Yeah, shrink wrap.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, easy to cascade.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They are heat resistant too.
There's a question about GANs, but I think we answered it previously. Fio asks, what a GANs came in the middle of the deepest coil? What if a GANs come in the middle of the middle coil? And what a GANs come in the highest coil? I'm thinking we need three different GANs. Is it right? And that's what... Armin answered earlier, right, Armin? You need three different GANs in
yes, correct.
Top, you know, medium, and lower yes, levels.
It's about, and GANs is that you apply on a coil. It's totally separate. Even whatever you apply on a coil, it's going to be connected to you. Just understand when you work with it.
Thank you.
Marco can say.
Yeah, it's... Depends what you want out of the system. There are hundreds of options, so you have to have some idea what you want to achieve. Then you use different guns, different fields. There are many combinations. But you have to follow this principle, these basics about field interactions. And what we have on the board, control of these two major fields, gravitational fields and magnetic fields. And with this control, you achieve different effects, different results. So the next step is to control the fields. Now we have the way how to produce energy in plasmatic way. And the next step is to control this energy to achieve these different fields. And in these pictures, to explain us how to control it. To put more gravitational or more magnetical. And you have all spectrum of these field strengths. This is job for the future. We have to make charts of different field strength, and this is job for next hundreds of years. Here we have basics, and we have to follow these basics. But it's a big job to make like measurement system or a way to describe these fields and to get, let's say, field strength of the water in certain position. So if we are moving to the plasma, we are moving away from the matter. So even when we are in the space, are we going to consume water? Are we going to consume food? Or are we going to absorb just the field that we need? So we have to decide in which direction we are going. If we are going to consume food, water, then we have to find a system to convert fields into the matter, back to the matter again. The other option is to absorb fields from the environment directly in our body. So instead of using our digestion system to convert matter back to the plasma, fields that are absorbed by our body, by our cells, which are in a gas state, we can absorb these fields also directly. In this case, we don't need the digestion system. Fields can be absorbed directly from the environment. Let's say we can put certain type of guns on our stomach, and fields of this guns material are radiated in its environment, so they are absorbed also in our stomach, in our intestines, and they are feeding our lymph or our blood system. In this case, we don't need to use this conversion system, which is our stomach, which converts matter back to the fields. So depends what we want. Do we still want to have pleasure with eating food, or are we going to the next step? Using of plasma energy directly. So this is a big question. The same is with heating. So one way is to heat all the environment like we are doing at the moment, but we can also release fields which in interaction with our cells of our body release certain field strength that we feel this as the heat inside our body. So we are heating only our body, not the environment around us. So that's the next stage also. When we work with the plasma, we have to look at the interaction of the fields and try to achieve different interactions that these interactions are releasing fields that we need for certain operation, let's say for heating. We can still do the old way, but the question is, do we want to be so inefficient and heat all the environment, all the buildings, all the air around us? Or we just take the energy that we need at the time we need, at the point we need? So this is a shift of thinking, of understanding, change of perception, how we are looking to things around us, how we understand all the phenomena that are happening around us. So with this Magrav's energy unit, we have Magrav's energy release, and we have to find out how to use this energy directly, not to convert it back to like matter energy, what we are doing now, but use it directly. Let's say to supply food or energy of food, or supply energy of water to our body directly. Not to convert back to water and then drink water, and inside our body this conversion is done again by our body. So do we need this conversion and back conversion two times? These are the questions that we have to answer. So, but we always dictate our environment or condition of our body with our state of mind, with our thoughts, with our emotions. And energy in certain strength will be useful for somebody, but will not be useful for somebody else. Even we have to understand that how we condition ourselves in respect to our environment, in respect to people around us, we dictate what we will absorb or what we will not absorb. So what is pain for somebody is joy for somebody else. So we have to look at totality, not just partially. Let's say we dictate if somebody is touching us, are we going to consider this as for example, if you touch a woman in a public, women that you don't know, most probably she will hit you back. But when you touch your wife, this will be considered as something nice. So depends how we condition this, how we accept these emotions. The same is when we go to the doctor. We allow doctor to touch certain parts of our body that we are not allowing to touch everybody. So we dictate the condition. And the same is here with plasma. We dictate what are we going to absorb or what we are going to reject. And we have to look at totality, not just one side. So even if we have the same system that release fields for somebody, these fields will be useful for somebody, will not be useful. Somebody else can reject these fields. Okay, anything else? Or I'm talking to myself.
We can hear you, Marco. I'm here. I'm just trying to get Curl back in here. I think his mic is unmuted. Curl, can you hear us?
My mic, Ernie.
Yeah, hi, Bernie, but just one moment, please, okay?
Sure.
Curl? Hi, Carl, but we don't hear you. I see your video, but I don't hear you. Maybe your mic came unplugged.
I have two magnets here. And when I'm holding one magnet, it's just like I have a matter. I don't see any fields here in my hand. But can we say there is no field around this magnet? Yeah, if we just look at the matter, we can say there is no field here. But when I'm holding the other magnet in the other hand and I'm trying to put this magnet together, I position them in the way that they repel each other. So I feel the force of the fields of these magnets. So even if I don't see the fields, I see only the matter. I cannot say the fields are not here. Everybody can do this experiment. I cannot explain, but if you have two magnets and try to put them together, you will feel the fields of this magnet. So same is with everything around us. Everything is releasing fields. The same is with our thoughts, with our emotion. They are releasing fields. We cannot see them, but they're here. They have their effects in the environment. They have their effects to other beings. A lot of experiments have been done with this, especially with water. If you put yourself in a special emotional state, you can influence the water. The property of the water changes. So water has this interesting property that remembers the environment that is seen. It has property of somehow we can say it has a memory, and we can use this also for a way to feed ourselves with special energy. People have done these experiments, putting different guns around different reactors around water, and water was the taste of the water changed. People can feel the taste of apple, or banana, or orange, or whatever they have put in this configuration. So we can use this property of the water. It's not something that is observable to us, but in the background, fields are always active. And we have to use this property of the fields. That's what we are learning here in plasma technology. Property of different fields and how to use them in a proper way. Not to harm anybody, but to use them in a good in good direction, let's say, so that we don't hurt any. Just take 2 magnets. And you can feel the fields. Okay, anything else? Is Carl online?
I have a question, Marco. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yes, I want to know how to gradually add the low to speed up the coating of the outer wire of the system.
Sorry, I didn't understand the question.
Yes, I want to know how to gradually add the low of the system to speed up the coating of the outer wire.
Consider your system 2 kilowatt and add slowly to minimum 2 kilowatt. And you see if it's holding, add another one. It's a roughly.
Okay, so I need to add the 2 kilowatt appliance, right?
Yes, then add more. You know,
yeah,
as it,
add more.
Leave it like, you know, day or two or three and add more.
Okay, thank you, Maman. I know. Thank
yeah,
you.
You should start slowly by, let's say, 200 watts or let's say first 3 days and then you add the gradually.
Yeah, maximum two kilowatts. You consider that and slowly add. Is right.
Okay, I know. Thank you.
Okay, we probably should wrap things up in the next couple of minutes here.
Bernard did have also something to ask there or to talk about. Was that right, Bernard?
And there's also someone that has a question in the chat that really wants to get it answered about the about putting caustic into seawater and to create GANS that way. And why not use that if it's a mixture of GANSes? Then why wouldn't that work?
Try it, I would say.
Like,
there is no limitation, you know. Try it.
Richard was trying it in his system, and Phoenician as well has mentioned that, and some of the people that he works with are using that. So we'll get some sort of results from the field, as it said. And I don't believe Mr. Keshe has used that technique. Is that true, to your knowledge, Marco?
No.
I know the technique, you know, the salt water when you can create like monatomic gold. So it's the same thing. Yeah, almost.
Right.
They're talking about the almost.
Well, in a way, but with the Ormus technique is quite exact, is the way I understand it. You're under certain conditions and you have to control the pH exactly and so on, as opposed to just dumping a tablespoon of caustic into some seawater and whatever you happen to get out of it is what you get. That's sort of more of a cross-section of GANS, as it might have virtually anything in it because there's so many elements in seawater and it's so variable.
Rick, I actually sent them the links to a couple of things so that they could see the other methods of creating it. It's in the, I don't know if it's in the chat room, but I'll put it in the chat room now. And yeah, you are correct. There are several ways of doing it, like washing the Ormus off and having a controlled situation. And the most easiest way is to just put the caustic in the water. And yeah, you're correct. You get a lot of impurities and everything like that. And that's not something that they would recommend for you to take into your body. So that I was only thinking about external use for that. So maybe I don't know if I should have said that.
Well, that's the thing about it is this reactor is connected to our bodies. So whatever you put in your reactor is connected and will influence your body. So if it has, for example, you know, heavy metals and so on that you don't necessarily want in there, maybe that will be reflected in what goes into your body. So the GANS is very important because it has a plasmatic principal energy connection with all the atoms in our body, all the plasmas in our body. So in a way, the seawater makes sense in this in a way because of the our bodies have many different salts and many different elements in them and so on, and probably in this more or less the relationship of seawater. But on the other hand, swallow a few mouthfuls of seawater and see where it gets you, so to speak. So it's a bit of a delicate situation in a way, but it's an interesting experiment to see if these reactors with the
but if you want to make powerful reactors, Rick, you need a heavier materials.
Yes, but is that what we want to do? Is that what we want to create in the home as a powerful reactor, or do we want one that will just do the job?
Yes, you know, for now, we can understand that, you know, it's easier to make because we have everything, you know, what we need. We're not looking heavier materials. You know, this is more than enough.
Right.
We have in our hand.
Perhaps in the next stages of reactors,
definitely we're going to create.
We will need the heavier GANSes.
More powerful plasmas.
Definitely.
Well, that was one of the reasons on why I was talking about removing the materials out of the bags and seeing if I could seed the plastic bags to get a more concentrated material. I'm just playing with it right now, so I'll get back to you guys. Also, seawater is about as close as you're going to get to human blood. There's very little difference except for, I believe, the magnesium and a bit of chlorophyll. So if I was thinking of using any kind of devices for the body, for as far as the health units are concerned, then I would have to think that the seawater GANS would probably be more applicable there. Now, when we're talking about it as far as its energetic level, I kind of look at the matter like one of those guys in the coffee shops that are making those coffees when they pour them and they hold their hand down really low. He doesn't really care about both cups. He's talking about what's inside of it. So I'm looking for the gradient, and I'm trying to create those peaks and valleys wherever I can. And if I have a very low level GANS and I add a high level GANS, and I'm just creating gradients everywhere. So
yes,
that's
you're correct. Interaction is more.
That was my reason behind.
You have all the elements in between.
So as to create kind of like a cascading effect on where we're going from top to bottom, bottom to top, baseline math basics.
Don't forget, in seawater, we have all elements.
There's your 9 coming up again on the board. 0.9%. I guess that's the salt ratio for the body. But I don't think it's...
Yeah, for body. When we are doing things for our body, we should use 0.9%. That's what they're using salt solution in pharmacies and whatever.
Yeah, that's
a 0.9 solution of salt solution.
It's a saline solution, they call it. I think if you look up saline, it's not it's not that's the right. Same as sea salt, though. It is a specific specific body salt or something. I think it's maybe potassium. instead of chlorine. Anyway, we probably should wrap things up here so we can have our lunch break. Hello?
Yeah, maybe do we want to just continue after lunch then?
I think so.
Is that how we were going to go? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have lunch break now, 1 hour or so, and then we continue at 2 o'clock Central European time.
Okay. That sounds great. Thank you very much, Marco. And that wraps it up for the morning session for Wednesday, November 4th. This is the Blueprint Teaching at the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. Thank you, everybody, for attending, and we'll see you in the afternoon session.